Hi, in this video you're going to learn how to connect to the EdTech2 server. This is often called creating a site definition or creating a site in Dreamweaver, but we're going to first show you how to do this in Dreamweaver, then you're going to learn how to use Filezilla, which is another tool that you can connect to the EdTech2 server, and then we'll finally show you how you can use an add-on extension and Firefox to do the same. So the first thing is you have to have actually an EdTech2 account set up. That's something the Department of Educational Technology will take care of once you've signed up for 502. If for some reason you haven't taken 502 but you need it for another course, just simply contact us and we will set you up an account. Another thing to keep in mind with EdTech2 account is that depending on where you live, there have been people who live at certain different countries throughout the world. They've had problems connecting to the EdTech2 server. So ultimately, we provide the EdTech2 account for you as a benefit, but we recognize that it does not work for everyone. And so sometimes you might have to find alternative web space. But even more importantly, sometimes you might want to actually intentionally seek out your own web space, because one thing to always keep in mind about your EdTech2 account is 1 year after you graduate, the files are deleted. So let's get going and let's dive in. How do you connect to the EdTech2 server? So when you go into Dreamweaver, and to do this, you actually have to have Dreamweaver CS6 or Dreamweaver CS5.5. If you are using an older version of Dreamweaver, you're then going to have to actually use Filezilla or another FTP tool to connect to the EdTech2 server, simply because some added security that we've recently added. So to create a site in Dreamweaver, I open Dreamweaver, and you can work from this page, the welcome screen, but I like to go up to Site, New Site, and then I'm going to call this EdTech2. One of the first things after you name it is it wants you to find a local site folder. This is a place on your computer where you're going to store all your files. Ideally, this is a place that you never move this folder, because one of the best things that you can always do when you're creating websites is pay careful attention to how you manage your files, where you locate them, and try not to move them. So in this case, I'm going to click on the folder and I'm going to go into my documents, and in my case I'm going to create a folder called websites. You might call this folder EdTech2, MET, whatever you want, Boise State. And then within this I'm going to create a folder called EdTech2. Last but not least, I'm going to create a folder called 502. You will likely want to create a folder for every course that you take in the program, or at least every course that you end up using the EdTech2 server. So you'll notice that I created a folder called Websites, within that a folder called EdTech2, and then a folder called 502. Now go back to this and just select EdTech2. And so that's what I'm going to do. And so then later when I create other folders for other courses, I can just use the same connection. When it choose, then I have to hit Server. This is where you have to hit this little plus sign, add a new server. Server name I'm going to call EdTech2. And this is the important thing, and this is what you can't do with older versions. For instance, Dreamweaver CS5 or CS4, is you have to use explicit encryption. So I'm going to select that, and then under the FTP address, edtech2.boisestate.edu. I'm going to put in my BroncoWeb username and then my BroncoWeb password. Now there's talk about the university changing BroncoWeb to something called my.boisestate.edu. It's unclear right now what and how any of this will really change. Likely it's just what we call it. But your BroncoWeb username is essentially what you use to log into your email, and then your BroncoWeb password is the password that you use to get into your BSU email. Keep in mind, these have to be updated every 90 days. And so one of the biggest problems students have later on in the program when they find they can't connect to the EdTech2 server, it's more often than not simply a password issue. Once this is set up, you can hit Test. And this is what you want to see. It says that I was able to connect. So just like that, I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to hit Save. And I'm going to hit Save. And then in Dreamweaver, I'm going to close this welcome screen, and I can actually, if I want to, just start with a new HTML file. You'll notice that there's this option over here on the right called Files. If you don't see it, under Windows, you can always make sure to select it and you'll see it come up, and you can move stuff around here if you want more space, but right now what it shows me is my local view, and that means the files on my desktop, on my computer, or I can change it to a remote view. So that will show me what is actually on the remote server. Similarly, if I have other site definitions, I can connect to other sites by using this dropdown. In this case, I'm interested right now in looking at my EdTech2 local view. And you'll notice that I can see that folder I created. And so this is a matter of where, if I have files within this, I can simply hit the put the arrow and upload them. But often what I'll do is I'll click this little button in the corner, and what it does, this ability to expand, it gives me this traditional view, which is what a lot of FTP clients will look like. They might have local over here and remote on the right, so they might switch these, but essentially they have a similar idea, and the idea is that you take files on the right and you drag them to the left. Dreamweaver gives you this arrow to put and get, so basically upload and download files. Sometimes that works really well. Sometimes you might find you do better to actually see and intentionally drag things where you want. The risk always of dragging and dropping is that you want to make sure you put it in the right folder. Because one thing to understand is file management is key. Put it in the wrong place, you will never find it, or you won't be able to find the URL that directs other users to access that file in your account. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to disconnect. I'm going to collapse. And I'm going to create my first file here. So I have a new file here, and I'm going to type in. So let's say I wanted to do something like this. I can highlight it, hit bold. You always want to put a title. So now, when I go to save it, so there's a few steps to all this. I want to make sure I save it in my 502 folder, because everything I do in the 502 class, I'll save in the 502 folder. If I'm working on another class, maybe 506, I would save everything there. In this case, I'm going to call this index.html. Usually your home page, you want to call default or index.html, because then the server will recognize it as a home page. So I'm going to make sure I save it in the correct place. And once I do, I'll notice over here, I can see it. So what I'm going to do is, so now I'm going to make sure I'm connected. And you always notice that it looks like a little plug. So now I'm connected. I have the green light. Notice when it's not connected, you don't see that green light. And I'm going to hit expand. And I always hit this little refresh to make sure I'm looking at what I need. I'm going to make some space so I can see I have a 502 folder and I have my index file. And so in this case, I already have on my personal space on EdTech2 a 502 folder. If I didn't, you could always just drag the 502 folder and drop it at the very top of your remote server. But in this case, because I just want to basically add a file, I'm going to click and drag it over into my 502 folder. And it says this has been modified. Do I want to replace it? I do. Do I want to include dependent files? Dreamweaver will ask you this. And essentially, if you have images, CSS files, and all of this we'll talk about later as the course progresses in 502, these are things that you would hit yes. But if, in this case, I don't have any dependent files, I'm just going to hit no. And so there are times where you're just going to hit yes. There's times where you hit no. You just have to be careful and comfortable. Have you updated the CSS? If so, then you want to hit yes, because you want it to upload both the HTML file and the CSS. So now I'm going to open a web browser, and I'm going to take a look. Yeah, so now I have Firefox open. And what you want to do is go to edtech2.boisestate.edu, and then whatever the name of your account is, and mine is my first name, last name. Usually that's going to be the case with each of you. However, if you have a common name, if someone, you might have a different Bronc web username, and so your account might be set up a little differently. And then if you remember, I saved my index file in a folder called 502, and then index.html. And so this is the same as here. And so, and if we go over here down below, if you remember, everything was saved in a folder called 502 index, And just like that, you can see over here, index 502. And so that is the way it works. And so with Dreamweaver, we just created a site, we connected to the EdTech2 server, we created a basic HTML file and uploaded it to our EdTech2 space. Couple key things to always keep in mind is you always want to name your files all lowercase. You want to have no spaces. And you always want to be very careful and cognizant of where you save them. And so in this case, on my local computer, I saved it in 502. And so when I uploaded it, I dragged it into the 502 folder on my web space. So now, let's actually jump back down here. We're going to actually close this file. And now I'm going to use a program called Filezilla. Filezilla is just one of many FTP programs out there. Filezilla is one that we're focusing on simply because it is open source, it's free, and it is cross-platform. So while I'm showing you on a Mac, it works on a PC as well. So once you've installed Filezilla, if you click on this little icon, you'll notice that you'll have this option here for site. So I'm going to click on New Site, and similar to creating a site in Dreamweaver, I'm going to call this EdTech2. And type in another host, edtech2.boisestate.edu. FTP, I'm going to select. And then rather than plain encryption, I'm going to use explicit. Then here, I'm going to change login to normal. I'm going to type in my BroncoWeb username and my BroncoWeb password. And we hit connect. So it gives me this prompt, basically wanting to know, do I trust this? And I do, so I'm going to hit OK. And so the way that Filezilla works is you'll notice that the local files are on the left, the remote files are on the right. So in this case, I can make some room, pull some things down. And what I can do is you just do things a little differently. So if you remember my 502 folder I created, if I go into Documents, created a folder called Websites, folder called EdTech2, and so just like that, I can see my 502 folder. And if I click within it, you'll see down here that here is my index file. So the way that this would work is I'm going to open this file. I'm going to update it. I'm going to save it. And I'm going to close it. So then I actually go to Filezilla to upload it. So here's my 502 folder. I'm going to click on my index. I'm going to drag it into my 502 folder. And it's basically prompting me, do I want to override it? I do. If I go back to Firefox and I refresh, you'll see that it was updated. So last but not least, we're going to talk about a third option. And this is something that Firefox is one of the browsers that most of our students use. And so if you look under Tools, you can always add add-ons. And so in this case, I added an add-on called FireFTP. So if I go under Web Developer to FireFTP, so in FireFTP, I'm going to hit Create a New Account. I'm going to call it EdTech2. Then I type in edtech2.boisestate.edu for my host. The ID login, once again, is my BroncoWeb username. And this is the part you have to remember is to go to Connection and choose SSL or TLS should work. So let's start with SSL. I hit Connect. And it connected. So now let's disconnect. If I go back, you notice that if I go to best, and hit OK, connected once again. And so, just like before, if I go to Dreamweaver, I open my file, I make some changes, I save them, I close them. So then if I go into FireFTP, if I go to my documents, and if I go to my website folder, my EdTech2 folder, and my 502 folder, I will find the index file. I can see the time, and that always helps me understand when I updated it last. And then I take my index folder, and I drag it into my 502 folder. And then it asks me if I want to overwrite it, and I do. And if I go over here and hit refresh, I can see the change was made. So I just showed you using three different tools. First, Dreamweaver. You have to use CS 5.5 or CS 6. Then using Filezilla, a free open tool that you can download. as well as using FireFTP. Keep in mind there are a ton of other FTP tools out there. So find one that works well for you. But the basic idea is FTP tools allow you to upload and download files to your EdTech2 site. So throughout the rest of this course and EdTech 502, you will learn a lot more about how to create files, what CSS is, and all these different terms that you've heard me mention quickly. But now you should have a basic idea of how to connect to your EdTech2 account. Thanks.